Tic Tac? No, let me open it.
Oh.
Pour it in here.
Thank you.
This man don't know how Tic Tacs work.
Just Christmas flavor?
Yeah.
Christmas flavor Tic Tacs.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yep.
Hey guys, let's do this. So today we're talking about our new picks for the awards, and then how stupid All-Star voting has become.
Oh my gosh, it's crazy stupid.
So stupid. Okay, so our picks.
Okay.
So MVP is what we're starting with, correct?
Yeah. This is where we disagree. You picked Jokic to start the year, didn't you?
I did a tie with Jokic and Luka.
Okay. Well, I definitely did not pick either of them, I'm pretty sure.
No, and you picked like Steph Curry.
Now I flipped to Luka, and he's fully on the Jokic
train. I'm on the Jokic train because...
And it's not even because...
Choo-choo, here comes Jokic.
He just thinks... He just wants that three-time MVP.
It's not just because of that, though. He's also very deserving of the award. And it's close between Jokic and Luka. I just think, especially defensively, Jokic edges out Luka. And then... He's 0.3 assists away from a triple-double, from averaging a triple-double.
That's true.
So I think just overall, I mean, Luka, sure, he's scoring a ton, but he's also not very efficient.
Luka's never been an efficient player, though.
Yeah.
But that's because he has no one else on his team to score with.
Fair.
So no one else on his team shot. He has to shoot every shot to get the team to win. And when Jalen Brunson was there, he had someone. Jalen Brunson was growing into his other player that he could do, and then the Mavs let him go because they didn't want to pay him a max contract.
Honestly, I said Josh should trade for Jalen Brunson before all the Donovan Mitchell and Gobert trades went down.
Mm-hmm.
I said one more. I said we're gonna win a title this year. Sign and trade for Jalen Brunson and Mike Conley.
Not if Gobert was playing like he was. My kid, no.
Yeah, but...
I don't know. We still could have, because Donovan Mitchell would have had 71 points.
71. Okay, so... I take Jokic.
I take Luka.
Yeah. I mean,
I think
it's close.
I think Luka's playing too good.
And I think we can both agree, though,
win it
that
this
is
year.
Close.
He's been the favorite every year by the media panel before the year for the past 3 years to win MVP, and Jokic has stolen it from him. And I don't think, out of three times, Jokic is going to steal it from him. Every time. I think at least one of the times Luka will take the award away.
Okay. Well, we can both agree that it's close.
Unless someone random like Jason Tatum starts playing out of his mind and his team keeps playing good.
Yeah, but he slowed down a little bit.
Yeah, just a little bit. He's like a dark horse MVP pick along with Mitchell. I think Mitchell's the true MVP.
My dark horse.
Because most valuable player, meaning the player who's most valuable on a team.
I know.
So Luka.
Like, that means Rudy Gobert should have won it like 2 years ago.
Nah.
Yes.
Nah. Because Gobert doesn't get you wins.
But he was the most... I mean, did you see what happened when he wasn't playing, though?
That's because our team was built around him.
I know. Exactly. So he was the most valuable
player. A true most valuable player is the player that is most valuable to a team. Like, the player who's most valuable. Not the best player.
Yeah.
But the player who was... Like, without them, your team would have...
Except
that means they're really valuable. So Jokic, because he carried his team to the playoffs last year by himself. We know he can do that. Luka's carried his team into contention every year.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd say Mitchell. Because Mitchell is carrying the Cavs to new heights we didn't think they'd make it to.
Yeah, but
so I'd say Mitchell's
my dark horse. My dark horse, SGA.
I don't, as good as SGA is, I don't consider him a true MVP because he's not carrying his team into contention like Jokic and Luka.
Yeah, but dude.
So he's not as valuable as.
Are they really trying to win, though?
If you put Jokic on the Thunder, they'd be in the playoffs.
Yeah.
If you put Luka on the Thunder, they'd be in the playoffs.
Yeah.
So SGA, I wouldn't put him in that race just yet.
Yeah. I don't know. He's my dark horse pick, though. He's putting up good stats. And the thing is, sure, it should be the most valuable player on the team, but. Let's be honest, it's really turned into just the best player in the league.
Yeah. Or the most popular player.
Yeah. So
Jokic has broken that trend though, because Jokic is a very boring player to
Jokic
watch.
Is the most boring MVP. But yeah, I'm a statistics kind of guy, so I gotta put Jokic above of Luka.
And that's respectable. Those two are definitely the top two. They've kind of flown away from everyone else. And then I feel like for the past 3 years, Giannis has just been hanging up third place. Like, what the?
Fags,
bro. A freaking title.
I know. He's just been third place. Yeah. But, okay. Depoy.
We both agree. Jaren Jackson Jr.
Triple J.
I just don't really see, like, last year there were all these amazing guys defensively.
I know.
Marcus Smart, Mikal Bridges, and Rudy Gobert. You're like, wow, those three? They're good. You could throw OG and Obi. There's not really that many guys this year that you're like, wow, they're like good defensively.
I feel like this year,
it's just kind of like
defense kind of like fell, and like
offense is so good this year that it's hard to measure the defense.
Exactly.
It's like, how really good is the defense, because guys are scoring on you even when you have like two hands in their face and you can't even see the rim.
Exactly.
What about that one guy on the Celtics? Who doesn't contest threes? What's his name? He just like jumps and covers the rim.
Oh, Luke Kornet is my depoy.
I love Luke Kornet because guess what? Everyone thinks it's so stupid, but if you look it up, his way of contesting threes, when he does that, people shoot 31% from the three.
Luke like, Kornet's my dark horse pick now.
I feel like he could. I don't think he will, but he maybe could revolutionize the way we contest three-pointers. Just cover the rim. Victor Wembanyama just reaches his hand up.
Facts, bro. Yeah, no, but my real dark horse pick, what did I say?
I don't remember.
I said Walker Kessler.
You did.
But
I like Walker Kessler, but he's a rookie, so. I said Mikal because Mikal's so efficient every year.
Yeah.
Herbert Jones.
Oh yeah,
Herbert Jones is a guy I think could
Herbert
win it in a few
Jones.
Years. I think future guys that will win it is Walker Kessler.
Oh yeah, Walker for sure.
Evan Mobley.
Evan maybe, yeah, I could see that.
Herbert Jones
and Jose Alvarado.
No, Jose's too old.
He's too old.
He's like, he got his rookie year. He was 24. Oh. He's not gonna have progression, and he's not gonna progress enough.
As much as he should.
Yeah.
Okay, what's next?
Most improved player.
Most improved.
Lowry.
It's a runaway.
There's no one else I really see with incredible stats better than they were last year that it's like, wow, they should definitely win it.
I mean, if you look up, like, the point, like, I think he's, like, 10 points up from last year.
He's at 25 right now, and he scored, like, 18 last year.
It's crazy.
It's a lot.
The rebound numbers are way up.
Unless he's like carrying a team. Yeah, he's getting 8 rebounds a game, like 4 assists a game.
No, he's getting 2.3.
He was getting 4 at one point. I think I'm remembering his stats from like 2 weeks ago. There was like over the past 2 weeks, Lowry has averaged 30 points, 10 rebounds, and 5 assists.
Yeah, but so basically, and then dark horse. I mean, we all know no one else is gonna win it, but Lowry Markkanen. But I gotta say Tyrese Haliburton for my dark horse.
Yeah, I'd say so too. Tyrese is very good this season. As much as the Kings, like, it's a mistake to trade Tyrese.
They got Domas.
Domantas Sabonis. I feel like Tyrese is a better fit with the Pacers and Domantas is a better fit with the Kings.
Yeah.
So even though Tyrese is better than Domantas, Tyrese would still be running the two. And that's not his natural position.
Bro, I always liked Tyrese Haliburton from the start. Okay, next rookie of the year.
Paolo. There's really no one else even in contention.
Dark horse.
I would love a narrative of Benedict Mathurin though.
Yeah.
Where he's like, I got picked 6, I was underrated, and then he wins it, and you're like, yes. But I feel like it would be better for him to not get rookie of the year, so that way he has more fuel, and he's like, I didn't even get rookie of the year, even though I deserved it. And he goes on later and becomes like one of the greatest players of all
time. There's so many rookies deserving a rookie of the year.
Yeah.
Walker Kessler is also deserving.
Walker Kessler's deserving because 23rd pick or whatever?
22nd, I think.
22nd pick.
And he's averaging...
crazy.
Look, he's averaging 2 blocks a game on... I think he's like 18 minutes a game right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's freaking insane.
It's 20 minutes a game, but it's basically the same thing. Okay, Clutch Player of the Year, that's a new award they have this year.
De'Aaron Fox.
There's no one else.
My dark
even
horse
close to how efficient is been Jordan in Clarkson. Time. My dark horse is Luka, but that's not really a dark horse. I just feel like Luka could take it from Fox just because Luka. And he.
Donovan Mitchell is also a dark horse, which is funny because with the Jazz he was never so clutch. Bad.
The thing this year, how he got his 71
it's because he
game,
tries.
It's because they didn't call
a lane violation.
No. The reason.
No, but that's also the reason he would have had 56.
The reason he got a 71 point game is because he passed the ball.
Yeah, I guess.
He had 11 assists that night. Yeah. Every time they double team him, he just passes it wide open guy and they hit the shot. And they go, well, we can't double team him because mm-hmm. he's just going to pass it. And so Mitchell could just go out a guy and score. They try and double team him again and he'd pass it to, I think it was Caris LeVert. Every time he'd like hit a three off a pass.
It's also because he's actually trying this year. Okay, moving on. Sixth man of the year. Nobody is deserving of this award.
I really want Tyus Jones because as much as Jordan Poole is deserving of Sixth Man of the Year, he started too much because Steph has been out.
Yeah, he's only one game away from not qualifying, and we all know he's gonna. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So he's gonna start one of those games.
So. Mm-hmm. So that's our awards picks. Moving on. Yep.
The All-Star voting.
All-Star voting is terrible.
Terrible. On pause.
Okay.
All right.
We're leaving that in.
This, I hate this the most. No, I don't, because.
I do hate this, actually.
Because Austin Reeves is on here. But the thing I hate second most is that Kevin Durant and LeBron James lead the vote every year, even though it should be Luka over LeBron or Jokic over LeBron.
Yep.
And I still think Kevin Durant shouldn't be there. I think it should be Tatum. But somehow LeBron and KD get it every year because of their names.
Mm-hmm.
Funny thing is, one year they were leading at both of them, but KD was in the West and LeBron was in the East.
Oh my gosh, that's goofy.
That is kind of goofy. Okay, the front court. Really, the only discrepancy I have is that Paul George is above Laurie.
Yeah, well, and what? Andrew Wiggins is not an all-star.
He's always gonna be up there because he's with the Warriors fans.
He's and not putting he up all-star
it,
numbers.
He deserved it last year.
No, he didn't.
This year, I think he deserves it as a, oh, someone got hurt. Definitely Andrew Wiggins should be next.
At the all-star vote last year, though, sure, at the end of the season, he may have been deserving. But if you look at his stats from last year, or before the all-star vote, he was averaging 13 points a game.
It's because the Warriors were so good and they were like, well, who else is doing anything besides Steph? Wiggins? I don't know. Like, what?
It's because Warriors fans. This is the problem with the fan voting is that these big markets get players like Kevon Looney in the top 10.
Kevon Looney's in the top 10 above Kawhi, above Domantas Sabonis. What?
Is Sabonis not even on
there? Sabonis isn't even in the top 10.
Sabonis should be an all-star.
Yeah.
For sure.
Here's the discrepancy I have. Andrew Wiggins, Paul George should be below Laurie because Paul George hasn't really played good this year.
At the moment, so
it's because of Paul George's big name that he's there. Andrew Wiggins is there because he's in a big market. I personally think Andrew Wiggins deserves to at least be on there.
They take five guards and seven forwards from the from each conference. Laurie Markkanen is seven right now. So he would barely be an all-star, which is unfair.
I think that because the GM and the players get votes, I don't think Paul George will be voted by the GMs in. I don't think Andrew Wiggins will be voted by the GMs in. I think Laurie will be voted over those two.
But the thing is...
And I don't think Kevon Looney's going to get... I think GMs are going to vote Domantas Sabonis in.
But the thing is, with the amount of fans... Because fan votes are worth half of the staff votes.
Yeah.
But... There's so many fans and only so much staff. So even like the fan vote numbers.
Fan vote counts for 50% of the entire votes. GM votes or worker votes in the NBA count for 25%. And then the players get another 25%.
The players vote mm-hmm. for other players?
The players get another
25%. Can the players vote for themselves?
Yeah, they can.
They can?
They can.
Jordan. But, Austin Reeves votes for himself. But basically, and Russell Westbrook
is so one spot away, right? Russell Westbrook is one spot below Clay.
One spot away from being an all-star.
How come Paul George, because of his big name, and LeBron, because of his big name, get so many votes that they're automatically in? But Devin Booker doesn't.
Well, Devin Booker's also been hurt.
And Russell Westbrook is above him. But Paul George has been gone.
I know.
You've never heard about Paul George once this year. I promise you.
Paul George
isn't worth it. Have you ever seen a video about Paul George this year in the NBA?
This video.
Well, no, I've never seen a video like, what's up with Paul George? Or, I know. How good is Paul George really? I've never seen a video like that come up from the NBA. It's like he's disappeared. Like, I completely forget about him unless I go watch a Clippers game. Then I'm like, oh yeah, he's a player, he's good.
But Austin Reeves is above De'Aaron Fox?
Yeah, this is what I'm saying. Yeah. This is the problem that LA fans, nothing against LA fans, but there's so many of you that you can vote Russell Westbrook and Austin Reeves above these
big-time players. Well, and the fact that they're being that biased and only voting in. Sure, I'm voting Clarkson every day, but he's also putting up
I mean, I'm voting Larian every day, but Larian's actually deserving.
Exactly.
You guys vote in Davis and LeBron, who are deserving.
Yeah.
Stop voting in, like, Reeves and Westbrook. Like, vote for guards you actually want to see play in the All-Star
game.
Then,
when you go to the East, you have... Where is... Oh, is he not on here anymore?
Who?
Oh, wait, guards. Never mind. Derrick Rose is above Darius Garland.
New York fans, listen to me. I know you really want a player. I think you deserve a player. Do you think Derrick Rose should be that player you deserve? Where did Jalen Brunson go? Derrick Rose doesn't deserve to be an all-star. Jalen Brunson is definitely an all-star. Exactly. If you want a player in, I am fully willing to vote Jalen Brunson with you.
Yeah.
Like, he deserves it. Why are you voting Derrick Rose? I don't understand.
Let me see this.
Could you explain it to me? I really don't know.
Yeah, so Derrick Rose is 9 above Darius Garland. Right now, Tyrese Haliburton will not be an all-star.
Tyrese deserves to be an all-star.
But then the thing is,
LaMelo's
above look at how stacked this is. I don't think Trey should be on here.
Trey shouldn't be an all-star this year the way he's
not played. This year.
Not this year.
Sorry, Tyrese Hawks should
fans.
Be
maybe next
right
year.
There at number 5. Jaylen Brown, I'm not sure if he's even deserving because of how good this is.
Jaylen Brown's been really
Why is DeMar DeRozan in the guards?
Because he's played guard this season because Lonzo's out.
Oh.
So he qualifies as guard this year.
Well, except hasn't Io been, hasn't he been the small forward? Io's been point guard.
And so with basketball, positions don't really exist anymore.
Fair.
So you can literally qualify, like I bet you could qualify Jokic as a guard if you wanted to.
Yeah.
He walks the ball up sometimes.
Nick Claxton.
Nick Claxton above Bam Adebayo. I get it. It's New York fans. I don't think Nick Claxton
honestly
deserves it above Bam Adebayo because Bam Adebayo is the only thing keeping the Heat afloat this season.
Paolo Banchero should be above Kyle Kuzma. Swap those.
Paolo Banchero should not make
that.
It.
He should.
He's a rookie.
So
he should not make it.
He's just because you're a first-year player does not mean you're not deserving of being an all-star.
Okay, but who should be there instead of Paolo? Bam Adebayo.
Fair. So I guess Paolo shouldn't. Yeah.
But you could take out Nick Claxton.
I know.
I think maybe...
So,
yeah.
All-star voting stupid.
I'd put in Evan Mobley and Jared Allen instead of those three, too. Take out maybe not Julius Randle.
Not... Yeah. I honestly...
I'd take out Paolo and Nick
I'm
Claxton.
I'm gonna be honest.
Put in, like, Jared Allen
all
and
these,
Adebayo.
All these second-year players kind of, like... Or, like, all the rookies from last year kind of, like, disappeared.
I know, no one's talking about them anymore, but it's like they're even better than they were.
They said
last
they're
year.
Not even that good, though. Like, they haven't improved.
Scotty.
I know,
is
but they
much
haven't,
better than he was.
They
last
haven't
year.
Improved as much as you think they should, and they've just disappeared off the face of the planet.
This is what I'm talking about. The NBA is, like, focusing so much on, like, these narratives with, like, Luka and Anthony Davis is actually back. And wow,
except
Mitchell had a 71
bad.
Point game. Well, he's back when he's not hurt. When he wasn't hurt last year, he still wasn't good. But he's good this year.
Yeah, so basically...
Good job, Lakers fans, for not giving up on him.
Alright, well...
I just think that an alternative is we have the fans vote in 25 guards, and
or something. Yeah.
Or like you have a selection. A certain amount of guards from the West and a certain amount of guards from the East.
That only the fans can vote for. Like maybe some statistical merits too. Mm-hmm. Like just anything else. But
so you can't just vote for every player.
Derrick Rose is actually deserving 5 points a game.
Yeah.
So there you go. Okay, thanks for watching.
Please, please, if you are a New York fan and you watch this, please explain to me why Derrick Rose deserves it over Jalen Brunson. We would love to know.
Comment below.
We would love to know, really.
See ya later. Probably at the trade deadline. Okay. Bye.